Airtable continues to ship out new updates for its interfaces at a really great speed. In this video, I'm going to be showing you two of the newer features that came out for interfaces, specifically how we can now group sections of a record detail into tabs, and we're going to take a look at copy-pasting filters for interfaces. So if learning how to build better-looking interfaces is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of Airtable and related no-code tools. And in this video, we're going to be taking a look at some of those new interface features that have come out in October and November of 2025. Now, before we get into the heart of things, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. If you're kind of new to Airtable, or if you just don't think you've mastered all of the basics, grab my free Airtable crash course. This training will walk you through the core pieces of Airtable so that you can start building better and smarter databases. You can grab that training at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course, and I'll share links wherever you found this video. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. We're going to start by explaining the backend database first. That way it makes a little more sense when we're looking at the front end and we can actually dive into the interface components. So this is an HR base. We're imagining some kind of onboarding for employees. So I've got 10 different sample employees, and we're going to be diving into Alex as an example. And if we were to scroll over, we're going to see a lot of things like a link to manager, so we know who Alex's manager is, a bunch of statistics or information about his employment, and then we've got links to two other tables. We're linking to assigned equipment, so we know what different equipment components Alex has. That's going to be in our second table here. And then we also have documents. So anywhere where we have brought in like onboarding documents for Alex, we can store those. And so these two tables, equipment and documents, are really here to support the employees table. So equipment here, what is the piece of equipment? What is the serial number? Now, if this were a live database, we'd probably have more equipment information. When did they check it out? When did they take ownership? When is it due back? Things like that. But for this example, we're just sticking to these simple fields. And then similarly, at the document level, we store all the information about this employee, the employment contract, their signed NDA, if we have a passport, things like that. Of course, when you're using Airtable for document storage, do so knowingly. Make sure that it is not in violation of any privacy or information like that. But in this example here, you can see that we are storing just an example PDF. Right? So we'll use that same document. But these documents, and here's the important part, they're linked to the employee, same with equipment. Because what we're going to be showing in the interface is the tabbed grouping. So let's go ahead and pop into interfaces now, and I'll show you how that comes together. So what we have here is a record detail page. That means we're diving into the information about the record. And so everything that is on the employee page or employee object, that is what is getting broken down here. Let me go ahead and make my screen a little more presentable by sliding that out. And that should be fine for now. We can go ahead and rock with this. So the record detail is where the tabbed grouping is going to come to life. So we have to be in that page type, right? And again, as I said, we're choosing the source. So if I were to click into the employee record here on the side, you'll see that the source is the employee's table. So that means that we're inheriting, or we're able to present, all of the information that lives in that table, including linked records, everything that's connected to that employee record. And now here on the right, after we've selected the employee, that's where we get the detail. So we could go through and cycle through different employees, and we're getting the detail here. Now, I just want to highlight that this is not the only way to get record details. You can also have other views where you enable people to click inside of a record, and you can then present the record detail that way as well. So both types of record detail pages, it's the same page type, and that's what matters here, that we're using the record detail page. So whether you have a selector like this on the side, or whether you are getting into a record through another means in an interface, so long as it's a record detail page, whether it's a full page like this one, or you've opened up the side modal, Either way, you have this capability inside of your tabbed groupings. Now, what we see here is a lot of noise, and frankly, it's hard to make any sense of all of these different components. That's because they've all been brought in without any kind of organization. So if I were to click into the detail itself, and I look at fields, we see that all of the fields are visible, but without any kind of organization. So the first step to using the tabbed groupings is to build groups. And in order to do this, this is a feature we've had for a while, we can come to the bottom and say add group. And now we have this new group here, which is similar in nature to this big group. Now by default, we just had the one group, but now we can come into the new group. And when we click into this, we have options here on the side to bring in fields. So by bringing fields into this group, we can start to organize the information on the page. Let's actually name this group first, just so that it makes a little more sense. And we'll call this profile data. So I like to show the group name, especially now that I have the information in the tabs, because I think it helps keep this a little more organized and neater. And I also want to highlight that we don't have to manually add those different things in the fields right here. We don't have to come in and add them here. We can also click drag from other groups, so we can transfer things from one group to another. So for our profile data, let's pull in the employee name. So I'm going to grab it here and just drag it on down into our new group. Same thing with the photo. This sounds like, you know, information that is pretty specific to the person or the profile. Maybe I'll grab email as well, drop it in here, and maybe the phone number. So you get the idea. What we're doing is just trying to organize the data and clean it up a little bit better. And note that this is perfectly click drag. You know, we just grab the element that we're looking for, assuming we've already brought it into the record detail, and we can let it go wherever we like. Let me bring in now another group and just clean this up a little bit more. So we'll add a new group down here. And this time I want to actually highlight one of those linked record relationships. This one will be the documents. So I'm renaming the group here, and I'm going to grab the linked relationship to documents and drag it down here. Now I want to change the way we see this linked information. So I'll select the documents, the field itself, and I'll change it here on the right-hand side to present in a view. Now by default, these documents are going to be presented in the list visualization type. This is the, you know, default setting that comes up when you present in a view. Now, for our means, because these are documents, maybe we want to see them in a gallery view. So we can bring in gallery and remove list. And now we get something like this that says, here's the employee contract. We see information on the card. So, you know, what do we want to share there? So you have a lot of customization options that were not available to us earlier in the first versions of Airtable interfaces. They're really coming a long way. But I want to call out that this is now a new group. So we have our profile data, we have our documents, and maybe we want to look similarly at assigned equipment. So I can add yet another group here. Let's rename this one. So I'll say assigned equipment. And just as we have already done, I'll grab this and just drag it on down. This is another linked relationship. Maybe in this case, I want to go with a view again, but I'll keep the list view. So I can kind of resize this and show what somebody has. You know, what are the different pieces of equipment that are checked out? And again, this is only showing the equipment that is linked to this user, or in this case, the employee record, right? So once I'm happy with my tabs, I can create as many as I'd like, and of course, add the information accordingly, like bring it into the tab where I want it. Now it's time to set up the organized tabs component. And this is where we're going to provide faster access to our team so that they can drill down to the information they're looking for much more quickly within the interface. Rather than having to scroll through all of this information, let's give them those tabs. So in order to do this, we click into the detail again here, and now we have groups, and we can go with the tab navigation. This is the new option. And when we toggle this on, any of the group names that we've created are going to be displayed up here, profile data, documents, and equipment. And now I can quickly and easily drill right down to that component. Now, I do want to highlight that this really just takes me to that section within the record. It does not open up a specific modal for that group. Now, that would be a nice feature, but we don't have that now. So all it's really doing is quickly navigating to that section within the information, But still, this enables us to get right to the point a lot more quickly. Because imagine a scenario where we are working within HR, we need to know what equipment Alex has checked out. We can flip through all the different employees, get right to Alex, and now click on equipment, and boom, we're taken right to the information we need within that record. So this is the tabbed groupings. Again, this works only in record detail pages within interfaces, and it works with both the modal, the side modal, as well as a full page record detail. Now let's jump into the second interface update that I really love. It is the copy paste function for filters. If you have specific filters on your information here, let's go to the record detail here and we look at the filter. So we might have multiple different versions of this record detail, multiple interfaces where we're sharing different things on those interfaces, but maybe quickly we want to say, all right, maybe for this example, we only want to see employees where the manager is Julia. So let's go manager is Julia. And so these settings now are now established that we are automatically looking at Julia's direct reports. We're not looking at a full list of employees, but Julia's. And that is a key takeaway because that lives in our filters right here. And now we can copy and paste this, which is just awesome because if you have multiple filters in play, in this case, I have one and it's easy enough to rebuild. But if you have 10 different filters, having to create those manually in another interface leaves a lot of room for error. And it gives the opportunity where you might not build them correctly, and then you wind up deploying an interface that is not filtered the way you intended for it to be. So now we can do this. When you're setting up your filters, when you have them set for one particular interface, go ahead and click that gear icon and say copy. Now I'm going to head over to another interface page. This one is the manager view, but let's imagine that for some reason we wanted to apply the same filter and only show Julia's direct reports. Again, I click in here. Remember that I've copied those filter settings. I go filter by, I come in here and I say paste. Just like that, I now have the exact same filters brought from one interface page to another. And this is going to save you, as I said, a ton of time because you're no longer manually rebuilding these filters, but it's also going to reduce error so that when you deploy your interfaces, you know that they are filtered correctly so long as you set up the filter correctly the first time. So these two new updates to Airtable interfaces, again, just continue to move the bar up and up. Airtable interfaces are getting stronger and more powerful by the day, and I hope you got a ton of value from this video so that you can build better interfaces for your team. If you have questions that we did not answer, swing by our website. We have a ton of resources available and offer free complimentary strategy sessions so that you can get direction and unstuck for your next Airtable build. That's it for this video. I hope you got a ton of value. Give us a subscribe and a thumbs up if you enjoyed this content, but most importantly, keep on building.